Hello friends, my name is Anand Poddar. So today we are going to start with the unit number 1 of computer organization, that is basic structure of computers. Let us go through the contents that we are going to discuss in this lecture. So the first one is functional units of a computer, input unit, memory unit, arithmetic and logic unit, and output in a control unit. Now let us go to the functional units of a computer. So as you can see in the diagram, so there are 5 main functional independent main parts of a computer. So the first one is the input unit. Second one is memory. Third one is arithmetic and logic unit. Fourth one is output unit. And the fifth one is control unit. So as you can see in the diagram, these are the 5 units or functional units of a computer. Now let us go to the what is called as input unit. So as you can see in the diagram, these are the various input devices. As you can see here, joystick, you can say it as a used for playing games, mouse, mic, camera, scanner and keyboard, or you can say a tablet. So these are all input devices or input units. So let us see what is an input unit. So as you know, the input unit always the computer accepts coded information through inputs unit which read the data. So if suppose in a keyboard if you are pressing a key, so whatever the input it is given, it will be accepted in form of a coded information by the computer. So this is how the computer reads the data from the input unit. Now as you know, the most well known input device is keyboard. So how it works here is, whenever a key is pressed, the corresponding letter or digit is automatically translated into its corresponding binary code. So suppose if there are a number of keys in a keyboard, so if you press a single letter or you can say a digit, so that digit will be automatically converted into a binary code. So each letter has a corresponding binary code which will be translated by the computer, and this binary code will be transmitted over the cable, or you can say through wire, to memory or processor, so that it can store the input data. The another input device here is microphones. So microphones are used to capture audio input which is sampled and converted into digital codes for storage and processing. So microphones, when we speak something, so whatever the voice we recorded, or we can say it as an audio input, so the audio input will be converted into a digital codes, or you can say a zeros and ones. So these zero and ones code will be stored by the memory unit, and further it will be processed. So this is about the input unit. The next part here is memory unit. So these are the, you can see in the diagram, these are the various memory devices, primary and secondary memory in the computer. So RAM and ROM, or you can say a disk, pen drive, hard disk. So these are all the memory devices, or you can say a memory units of a computer. Now the function of memory unit is to store programs as well as data. So whenever the input device reads the data, it will be converted into a binary code. So that binary code or data will be stored by the memory unit. So in this memory unit, there are two types of storage, primary and secondary. So what is the primary storage here is, it is a fast memory that operates at electronic speeds. So primary devices are always fast that operates at the electronic speeds, or example you can take it as a hard disk. So whatever the programs or input, it should be stored in the memory when they are executed. So suppose if you are executing a C program or any other program, it must be stored in a memory so that we can execute at any time. Now how this data is stored here is, each of the data will be converted into a single bit, or you can say a binary bit. So these bits are stored in form of a cell. That is, each cell can store one bit of information. So if there are four bits, four cells are required for storing one bit. That is, each cell will store one bit of information. So whatever these cells are there, it will be read or written as individual cell slot, and it will be processed in a group of fixed size called as words. So the memory is organized so that the contents of one word having n bits. That is, suppose if you have four bits, so four bits is called it as a one word. If you have five bits, group of five bits, it will be called it as a one word. So each bit will be stored in the form of a cell, and a group of cells, it will be called it as a one word. So it can be stored or retrieved in one basic operation. So next unit that will go here is arithmetic and logical unit. So as you can see in the diagram, this is the arithmetic and logical unit. So once the data is stored in the memory, and if suppose if you want to perform some arithmetic operations, so most of the computer operations which are performed in the ALU of a processor. So consider an example. Suppose there are two numbers which are located in memory. So two numbers have been accepted from the input devices. It is stored in the memory, and these two numbers has to be added. So to add them, the memory unit will carry these operands, and they will be brought into the processor. That is for the actual addition. So this addition will be always carried out by the ALU. Also, other arithmetic operations such as multiplication, division, or comparison of numbers will be initiated by bringing the required operands into the processor. That is, it not only does the addition, it also does the other arithmetic operation as well as the logical operations. So whenever operands, or you can say numbers, are brought into the processor, these numbers must be stored in a high speed storage element called as register. So as you can see here, A and B are two operands. So A will be stored in one register, B will be stored in one register. So register is responsible for storing the operands. So after storing the operands, the operational code, or you can say the result, will be stored in the Y, and this result will be come out as a output. So each register can store one word of data, or you can say a group of n bits. Now next unit is here is output unit. Now these are the various output devices, and you can see here monitor, microphone, printer, headphone, speakers. So these are the various output devices, or you can say printer. Now once it is processed, or you can say it is stored in the memory and is processed, so the function of output unit is to send the process result to the outside world. Now we'll take the example of a printer. Suppose if you are given a print option, when you click on print, the clicking will be given at as an input to the computer. The printing process is done in the processor. After processing, whenever we get a page out of the printer, that is the output. That is, the output unit will, that is the printer, will be responsible for processing or making a printout of the page. Now these printers include mechanical impacts, heads, or photocopying techniques. So printer is always responsible for copying all the contents as well as other mechanical techniques. Some units provide both an output function and an input function. Such units are called as input-output units. So for example, you can take it as a graphic display. So in graphic displays also, it contains both input unit as well as output unit. The last unit we go here is control unit. Now control unit, it coordinates and stores an process the information of memory, arithmetic and logic, and input and output units, and perform the input-output operations. So, in all, the control unit acts as a nerve center, or can say a brain of the computer. So, it is responsible for coordinating all the activities of the all the four units, as well as perform input and output operations. As I say, it is the nerve center that sends control signals to other unit. So if suppose if a unit is not working, it can send a control signal saying that the device is ready to give the input, as well as it can sense their states. It is also responsible for input output transfers, that is, it may consist of input and output operation which are controlled by instruction of input output programs. So there are number of input output programs which will identify which all devices are involved and information to be transferred. So the input output transfer also will be controlled by the control unit. So actual timing signals are generated by the control circuits. So whatever the timing signals which are generated, or you can say a waveforms, are generated by the control signal, so control circuits for transfer of information. Now in this session we have learned about which are the functional units of a computer, what is an input unit, what is memory unit, what is arithmetic and logic unit, what is output unit, what is control unit. Thank you.